I've always been craving an opportunity to stand on the stage and under spotlight, because I think standing in the center of stage and the spotlight shining above with the roaring applause bursting the hall gives me a unique sense of achievement. But I don't want to just stand alone. I want to provide everyone who shares their love and their passion for the stage with an opportunity to stand on stage and shine in their own way. It makes me feel better than standing alone, and that's how the Patio Music Festival was born. It's a show for all the students to celebrate pop music culture and join the music festival train in the country, and at the same time provides them with a platform to showcase themselves. The Patio Music Festival, according to the original plan, was to host it on the school's patio. I came up with this proposal and discussed it with my advisor, and she was really responsive and supportive and helped me start my team in the afternoon. After the message was sent out, my classmates were very excited and many of them came to sign up for the project. So during that time, I often imagined how the patio would shine with the colorful glow sticks at night on the day of the music festival. And then my classmates would step onto the stage and start their performance. To me, the biggest challenge was definitely to overthrow the whole plan and start all over again within 1 month. The plan for the whole festival was almost complete by late June. But my teacher suddenly told me that due to the conflicts with other events held in school, the music festival had to be canceled. I was quite stunned by the news and got nothing in my mind. I didn't know what I should do next. For all of us had put a great effort into the event, and suddenly it had to be canceled. We felt that all the efforts was like washed away. And then we came up with an almost insane idea, which was to hold the music festival outside the school and start over. Then we started to rent the festival venue and look for the sponsors for the event by reaching out to our connections. We also expanded the scale of the festival and cooperated with many other high schools who publicized the event. We started from the schools and then to the whole city. We also created a group chat to calculate the number of audience and release the most up-to-date information about the music festival. So the original plan was to recruit 200 to 300 audience. And at that time, my team member thought it was impossible and thought I was daydreaming. How could that be realized? But as the publicity went on, more and more people got to know the music festival and consulted us about the event. In the end, the group chat had over 900 people, and the audience who signed up for it reached like 600 people, which far beyond our expectations. And we didn't even dare to dream that situations. So at that time, all of us felt extremely excited and also very stressed out. The night before the official performance, I stayed awake the whole night. But luckily, the effect and display of the final stage was quite satisfying, although there's still some flaws. But at that time, with the thrilling vibe and the positive emotions passed through the crowd, the whole feeling was awesome, and it was like a very major music festival. After witnessing the whole thing, I feel really relieved and also very touched. So I'm most grateful to my team members who have put great efforts to make this idea a reality, from finding sponsors to pay for the rental of the venue to reply to each message in the group chat. We worked together along the way as a team. For example, my deputy director plays a great role in publicizing the events She took the initiative to mobilize the whole team, wrote the advertising script, replied to many messages in the group chat, and all these things were in her charge. The stage performance was also brilliant and glamorous as the director of the stage took charge of all the stage design and double-checked every detail, including the costumes. Oh, I also want to thank my director for technology, who operated the machines and coordinated all kinds of audio devices. I'm also very grateful to my actors and actresses who worked very hard to rehearse for the performance. They would even rent a dance studio to practice for the programs during their spare time, and then send their video to me as for my advice. I was so touched when I saw this effort. It feels really cool to hold such a music festival in summer when I turn into 17. By using the stage as a medium to pass on my passion to others was also a very miraculous experience. So in my opinion, the Patio Music Festival is not the end of the story, but it's a start for new performance, for it provides students with a platform to show themselves instead of watching videos on their phones. They can truly stand on the real stage and show themselves and tell the world the beauty of passionate youth, and that is what I want to see.